Hey there, Nicholas from Growth Marketer here, and in this video, we're going to be looking at four free tools from Google that will help marketers get better results. Let's get right to it. Now, if you're already familiar with all of these tools and how they work, then this video is not going to be very helpful. But what I have found is that a lot of business owners and a lot of marketers who do not work with these tools on a regular basis sometimes get confused as to what exactly each of these tools do, if you really need all of them, and how they work together. So that's what I want to cover in this short video. So let's get right in to Google Analytics. This is most definitely the most popular tool of the four that we are going to be covering. And the best way to think about Google Analytics is it's the tool to give you the data and to capture that data on what's happening on your website or your app. But for our use cases, we're going to be talking more about websites. And so this is what's going to tell you what is happening, how many visitors you have, what are the sources of your different traffic streams, and what those visitors are doing in terms of how long they're staying on the page, which pages they're visiting, what type of events and actions and goals are taking place on your site. And it's going to give you all of that quantitative data so that you can then analyze it and make some decisions based on the data that you've been collecting. Now, I would say out of the tools that we are covering, this one is pretty much the one that you need to have no matter what. I mean, unless you're using something else for your analytics already, like an enterprise grade level software, like maybe Adobe Analytics, or maybe you are not a fan of Google products at all and you want to use something that's like a free analytics tool, it's almost like Analytics Lite, there are some good options out there. You could check out SplitBee, you could check out Clicky, and I know there's a lot of privacy first analytics tools as well, but Google Analytics is really the standard for what marketers use to analyze their web traffic and analyze the behavior on their sites from a quantitative standpoint. So I definitely encourage you to check out Google Analytics. Now, I'm not going to go into a lot of detail into the functionality and the setup of these different tools because I want to keep this video as just a quick overview of how the four tools work together and what their main role is. But I will say that Google Analytics is probably the one that has the most capabilities and therefore the strongest learning curve. It's going to take the most time to get familiar with it. You can see some screenshots here. But if you are learning Google Analytics for the first time, this is actually a good time to start learning it because Google recently rolled out Google Analytics 4, or GA4 as it's being referred to. And this is a complete redesign and rebuild from the ground up of what Google Analytics can do. And a lot of folks have not fully switched over yet. You don't have to. You could still run both the traditional Google Analytics and Google Analytics 4. But what I'm bringing this up for is that it is a good time to learn because you're basically starting from scratch along with a lot of the experts in the industry who are also learning GA4 for the very first time. So there's a lot of opportunity here to really become proficient at this tool. One thing I do want to mention before we move on to the next tool is that Google Analytics works with a lot of the other tools that we are going to be talking about. It works with Google Ads, it works with Google Data Studio and Google Optimize. Now, we're not going to be covering Google Ads or Google Data Studio for this video, but we will be talking a little bit about Google Optimize. And that one, there's an important connection between Google Optimize and Google Analytics if you want to use Google Optimize. But basically, I would say if you have a website and you want to learn what is happening on those pages, you really need to get Google Analytics set up. There's a free version, which is definitely the one that is most common. And then there's more of an enterprise level paid version. But I would say for 99.9% of the folks watching this video, you're going to be more than okay with the free version. So check out Google Analytics. Okay, let's jump into the second tool, which is Google Tag Manager. And a lot of folks are not exactly sure how is Google Analytics different from Google Tag Manager. So think of Google Analytics as the place where you're going to see the data. It's where you're going to get the data from in terms of what's happening with your website. It's where the actual analytics is stored. But Google Tag Manager is how that all happens. It's how those tags are set up. It's how your analytics code is installed. Think of it as the container on the back end of your website that is helping collect all of the data that you need, and it's firing all of your conversion pixels, it's firing your Facebook pixel, it's creating all of these different events and actions in the background so that you can then send that data to Google Analytics where you can then interpret it and chop it up and filter it. So these two tools work together very well. Now, you do not need to use Google Tag Manager. In fact, you don't need to use any Tag Manager if you don't want to. The concept is actually relatively new in terms of internet years, Because back in the day, you would just install all of the different tags and scripts and tracking codes on your website directly. And the problem was, it was very easy to get things lost, or let's say you have a large team and you don't remember exactly how you installed your Facebook pixel or your Google Ads code or something, some type of tracking script. And so there was all these different silos where the tag could have been added. And so what a tag manager does is it helps keep all of that in one place, and it makes it a lot easier to say, hey, I only want to fire a Facebook conversion event when someone reaches a thank you page. So you can set that up very easily with a rule in Tag Manager, and it's not complicated. You don't have to dig in to the code, and it's really made marketers' jobs a lot easier. So there are a lot of tag management solutions out there. I think Google Tag Manager is probably the most popular because it's free and because it's popular and because it integrates so well with the other Google products that we've been talking about, especially Google Analytics. So think of Tag Manager as your management tool for adding all of your tracking scripts, your Facebook pixel, your conversion codes, and all of that stuff. And then you're gonna send that data somewhere else to do the actual reporting and to see the data and to work with the data. Moving right along to the third tool I wanna cover, it's Google Search Console. And if you've been working in marketing for a while, you may remember when this was called Google Webmaster Tools. This is a tool that's specifically designed to help you monitor and increase your organic rankings. It's really an SEO tool, first and foremost. And it is a little bit complicated trying to figure out the differences between Google Search Console and Google Analytics, but I like to think of this as the SEO version of Google Analytics. I know that's probably not the best way to think about it, but this is an SEO focused tool. In fact, you can see here, it says improve your performance on Google Search. Search Console tools and reports help you measure your site's search traffic and performance, fix issues, and make sure your site is shining in Google search results. Now, this fix issues is really important, as well as the performance checks, because there's a lot of things that go into ranking on Google organically. There's a lot that goes into SEO. You have to get backlinks. You have to have great content that is tailored to specific search results. And then there's a technical layer to it as well. And so you want to make sure your site can be indexed. It is being indexed. It's loading quickly. There's no usability issues. And so a lot of that can be troubleshot with a tool like Google Search Console, which is free. And again, it works very well with the other tools that we're going to be talking about and the ones we've already covered, including Google Analytics. So my take on this is that if you're doing any type of SEO or you want to rank higher on Google organically, you should definitely be utilizing Google Search Console, or at least set it up. You could always come back to the data later on. Okay, we made it to the fourth and final tool that I want to cover, and that is Google Optimize. This is the newest tool of the bunch. It launched maybe 5 years ago or so, and this one is specifically to help you get more conversions and improve your conversion rate on your site by setting up A/B testing, multivariate testing, split testing, and personalization. So if that sounds really complicated, think of it like this. If you want to test different versions of your site, or if you want to personalize the experience on your website or on a specific landing page for a specific visitor based on some data that you know about them or where they're coming from or something like that, you can set that up for free with Google Optimize. Now, you need to tie your Google Optimize account to your Google Analytics property for that same website. So there's going to be this close connection between Google Analytics and Google Optimize. That's really important, and that's going to help you set up these tests and then report on the tests very easily. So the testing is really the main component in Google Optimize. I know they have the personalization feature, which I mentioned, where you can personalize the experiences by changing text dynamically and things like that. But most people seem to use it as an A/B testing tool. So if you want to test two WordPress pages, or you want to test a WordPress page against a different type of page that you built on the same domain, you can do that with Google Optimize. It's very easy to set up a test, and I'll go into more detail in a future video on how exactly to do that. But I would say, out of all the A/B testing tools on the market, this is probably the best one that's free, and it's from Google, so you know it's built as a quality product on par with the other tools that we mentioned. So if you're already paying for something like VWO or Optimizely, or if you already have A/B testing built in to your landing page builder, like with Unbounce, or maybe you're using an AI-powered A/B testing tool like abtesting.ai, then you can stick with those tools. But if you are looking for a free solution for quick and easy A/B testing, then you really can't go wrong by checking out Google Optimize. So there you have it. Those are the four tools I wanted to cover. We covered Google Analytics, Google Tag Manager, Google Search Console, and Google Optimize. And hopefully now you have the big picture of how these four tools are different, how they work together, and how they can help you become a better marketer and get better results for your website or for your app. Now, in future videos, like I said, I will go into more detail on these tools. Let me know what questions you have in the comments. I'd be happy to answer them. And if you're finding this content useful and you want to get more marketing tips, marketing tool reviews, then hit that subscribe button. Thanks so much, and I'll see you in the next video.